Michelle in world of hurt after disgusting purchase she was just caught making on solo trip. While Michelle Obama is still living a life of travel since leaving the White House, her trips have changed in recent months. Instead of traveling with her husband or any family member, she's opting for much more time alone. There's been a lot of speculation about her marriage, which seemed to be one out of convenience, but now that she doesn't have a public position to maintain certain pretenses for, the truth seems to be coming out. Michelle hasn't been home from her last solo trip for too long, where she went to an island in Spain for a long retreat away from her husband and teen daughter who is still in high school. Now she has just snuck off to New York City while Barack is busy trying to assume a position of power within politics behind the president's back. It's certainly not unusual at this point for Michelle to be vacationing again, but her purpose of this trip seems to be different than the others. The former First Lady is now in a world of hurt just a few days into her getaway after shocked onlookers saw what she was purchasing. Now, she's had to get her husband involved. He has just met her in the Big Apple. According to Page Six, the Obamas are prepared to drop a whopping $10 million on an apartment in the ritzy Upper East Side. This seems like an extravagant purchase to make when they just spent $8 million on their Washington, D.C., home down the street from first daughter Ivanka Trump. While the wealthy often have multiple residences, there could be one big reason behind this particular purchase which isn't sitting well with conservatives. Michelle is feeling the heat today from angry taxpayers who are sick of seeing her travel with an army of security, fly private, and buy luxury homes all over the place, all after having used the presidency to their financial advantage. It's almost like she's rubbing their new wealth in everyone's faces who struggled under her husband's presidency. What makes it worse is what else she could be securing a New York residency for. Former President Barack Obama and First Lady Michelle are eyeing an apartment in a historic building in Manhattan, multiple sources exclusively tell Page Six. The Obamas have been looking at Tame Gracie Square on the Upper East Side, situated between East End Avenue and East River Drive and near the mayor's residence, Gracie Mansion, according to sources who have seen the couple arriving at the building for viewings, Page Six reports, adding that a duplex apartment in that 10 Gracie Square just went under contract for $10 million last week. The Obamas could easily afford it, given reports that the bidding to the rights for their joint book deal had skyrocketed to a record $60 million earlier this year, the report added. Barack now commands a reported $400,000 for a speaking engagement, while Michelle, also a Harvard-trained lawyer, has taken a much more outspoken role at appearances and in the media. However, some are speculating as to if this potential home sell for them indicates that Michelle might actually be preparing for a run for office. She doesn't seem to be interested in working and has adamantly insisted that she has no interest in politics. However, New York State is a prime place for liberal politics and deep pockets to get candidates elected. Michelle would need to obtain residency in the state to secure a run for Senate if that is, in fact, her plan. While that's all speculation and hopefully not the case, she has the motive to want to do it simply because of her detest for President Donald Trump. At some point, she might even get tired of so much traveling, but it doesn't seem likely since it maintains her distance from Barack. Perhaps, for the same reason, is why she would want Pierre in a different state. Lucky for Michelle, she has a book of lies she and her husband get to sell to pay for these things and a lifetime of protection on the taxpayer's bill. Michelle's ritzy potential home in New York puts her in a prime place for parties, which she's known to love, and in close proximity to her sudden best friend, Hillary Clinton, who she's been seen palling around with to several speaking engagements to rip women apart who didn't vote for Hillary. If Michelle's plans are to run for Senate and then eventually for President of the United States, our only hope at that point is that her campaigns are as successful as her school lunch program. If she can't manage this simple task of managing what kids eat, then what would make anyone feel like she could run a country or any part of the government? It's preferable at this point for her to just stay on her travel schedule and out of the public's face.